So, first things first, I always forget to say this every time, and I have to record it and put it in the beginning because it's really important. I want to thank you to all my subscribers and new subscribers. People are awesome for actually subscribing to me. You guys are great, and despite what Robin's grumbling about, he thinks you're great too. So, yeah, thank you guys. You're awesome. I love all the comments too. Someone mentioned I was quiet last time. I'll try to be louder this time. I'm gonna do some adjusting and try to get everything the same level. Also, warning for baby general noisiness. I'm sorry. I cannot control him completely, and I just don't have a lot of time without him. So, let's hope this goes overall well. Hi everyone. It's my face, which you might not have seen in a while. Pardon the messy background there. That's my husband's dresser, which all the clothes don't fit in his dresser. Anyway, Robin's here too. Hi, little man. You ready? Join your audience. Yeah, he's pretty darn cute, huh? I think Moody was slinking in the background. Anyway, I don't know when this is actually gonna go up. It's gonna be sooner than my last update, because I'm sorry, my last update came quite late. Life happens, unfortunately. I'm on the bouncy ball thing. So let's see. Oh, sorry about my appearance too, no makeup. I am clean, at least. I've showered today. That's a big plus. Let's see. Oh yeah, I'm doing an actual face video because it's cold out, it's got snow. I haven't really been going out anymore. It's too hard with the baby. They do have coats where you can carry your baby in the baby carrier, but the problem is, like, they're expensive, and I just, no, I'm not gonna pay for one winter, you know? Maybe two if I have another kiddo. It's just not worth it. So yeah, I haven't really been going out. We live on a dirt road. So I can't really use a stroller either, at least not super easily. So there it goes, you know. Robin's getting bigger. At the point that I'm recording this, which let me check the date real quick. It's the 11th today. He is now 5 months old. He can roll over from belly to back, but he still doesn't do back to belly. He doesn't really like being on his belly that much, but we still do a lot of tummy time anyway. It's like, sorry, bro. What are you look? Oh, you're looking at Moody. Moody's over there. Looking at Moody. Your big brother Moody. Let's see, he smiles and laughs, and we've been having lots of fun. I spend my days hanging out with him, all the time. That's basically what I do. But I'll tell you, I got 3 pairs of PJ pants. Yeah, because that's what I spend my time in. But to give you an idea of the format of this one, my quick life update at the beginning here. There's gonna be my whips. There's a finish this time. I think there's a start as well. So we got some new stuff, as well as progress on my other projects. And yeah, I think that's most of it. I think so. And then I'm trying to think what else I got. Yeah, look at the camera. Like, no, Moody's way more interesting. Oh, and then I'm going to talk about future Stitchy plans, of which I have plenty. Future Stitchy plans, and I'm going to have a haul. Yeah, I mentioned that, but I'm going to have a haul too, right? I guess that'll go at the very end. Oh, my face is so red. My face is just naturally red like this, unfortunately, which is why I wear a lot of makeup to cover up how red it is and just make myself pale. But yeah, like, I don't have time to put on makeup. I don't have time to do that stuff. I'm spending my days with this person, and that's why, and when he's napping, I need to take advantage of that. I gotta take advantage of napping, because if he's napping, I have gotta be stitching or doing chores. or if it's a bad day and I'm really tired, I gotta sleep. His sleep has been kind of iffy. It's like, some days he sleeps pretty well, some days no. He does tend to go to bed late, usually around at least midnight. But then he'll sleep for 6 to 8 hours. So I shouldn't really be complaining, but I'm just so tired because I think those first 2 months nearly killed me or something. I don't know. I'm still trying to make up that lost sleep. So be it. I know, my life is kind of boring. Oh, Christmas happened. Christmas was awesome. I did get Stitchy stuff, which, again, you'll see. Funny thing, let's talk about this. So, my husband, his family has a tradition that I'm in conflicts with. They have Santa bring the Christmas tree, so they don't have a Christmas tree until actual Christmas Day. Which I kind of hate, because I personally like putting up the tree beginning of December, decorating it as a family, you know. I just think it's really nice to get into the spirit and be all like, yay, it's Christmas time. My husband claims that that's a very capitalistic, no, that's not the word he used, but he claims a materialistic way of doing it. I personally like to enjoy the tree and get excited about Christmas and then have Christmas instead of having the tree after Christmas. I don't know. So this is a big debate with us. I passive-aggressively bought a tree using my own saved money this year and put it up myself and decorated it myself. And I loved my tree. I recently took it down. So took it down within a reasonable amount of time. Oh, great. Dropped my phone. My baby's upset. Getting annoyed.
Yeah.
You said you're a good boy. I don't know how he's so cute. How are you so cute? I'm not as cute as you.
Yeah. You. Yeah, look at you.
That's you.
That's you. Yeah. That's you.
Yeah, he's really cute, isn't he? Sorry, y'all have to see baby. So anyway, that's... he wants to, next year, he kind of compromised with me. He was like, we could do it at solstice. I'm like, that's still kind of late. So we'll see how it goes. The nice part of their tradition is that they go to the top of this really high hill, which I didn't have to do this year. I stayed at his grandparents' house with Robin. They go to the top of this hill and get a wild tree. But the funny part about it is that they... Because they get these wild trees, they cut off the top of the tree, the top of the tree, because it's more scraggly, right? And they just have this middle chunk. This year they had this giant middle chunk of tree. Oh my god, it was so funny. And like, even Eric thought it was, oh, that's my husband's name. I like to call him Mr. Mully, save his anonymity, but anonymity. But he online goes by his full name anyway, so anyway, yeah, so his family, like, they had this, his dad got the tree after Christmas because we celebrated Christmas with my family, and they just have this giant hunk of tree, not even the top of it. The top thing actually kind of bothers me, like, I feel bad, but it's like, I totally get where his dad's coming from, like, you know, I understand my father-in-law's point of view and his logic. It's like, that's the best looking part of the tree, but it's like, you can't put like a star or anything, and it just makes it look crazy. Like, oh, yeah. I know, I'm a bad person. But anyway, we can all... Oh, I got my other baby. Look at my babies. Mwah. There's Moody. Moody's an adult cat now. I don't know how old he is. 8 months now of Moody. Still only one eye. He's a little mischievous dude. He's a small cat. I've never had a cat as small as Moody. I don't know if you guys can tell how small he is. Probably. I don't know. I haven't gotten him weighed. We did get him. Aw, yes, you nicely pet Moody. No grabby. Nicely pet Moody. I got him some shots, but I got them at the Humane Society, so they didn't weigh him, and I'm super curious. I think he's like a 7 pound or less cat. That's my theory. He's very little. Very little cat guy. Mwah. You're bigger than Moody. He's like 2 Moodies. So, yeah, I said you're Moody. You're Robin. Okay? All the kisses. They're all my little babies. You can go if you want, Moody. Sorry. He's trying to actually stay on the ball. He wants to stay with us. Aww! My sweet animals and my sweet baby. I got the life, guys. This is great. My house is still a mess, though. I'm sorry. I have been getting on it because Robin does nap better. But it's a little more unpredictable than I'd like. If he was more predictable in his naps, it would be easier for me to get the house clean. I do use time for stitching, obviously, when he's napping, but I try to get as much done as I can. The downstairs is way better than this room. Our bedroom's upstairs is pretty bad, except for his room. His room's pretty good, but downstairs is more acceptable. It's still not where I'd like it to be. It'd be easier if Robin was okay with, like, being left in, like, a chair or something. We do have one of those chairs that you can put the baby in, but he really doesn't like being in that for very long at all. Like 10 minutes tops, more like 5. And usually I can only get away with like putting him in there to eat so I can eat something really quick. It's just not a good enough thing. And he likes being in his little baby gym and he can do that for longer. But the problem with the baby gym is it's in his room and I don't really feel comfortable running around, you know. I'm too worried. He's like, if he's not in the same room with me, I'm gonna worry about him. I mean, he doesn't crawl yet, but still, once he's able to sit up, we have one of those bouncy things that he can bounce in. Maybe he'll like that more, and I can put it near the kitchen so I can do dishes. I'm also hoping, like, you know, good one of those bouncy things. I might get him one of those. We might get him, like, one of those, like, exercisery things. Not one of the ones that has wheels and they can move, just a stationary one. Because the pediatrician told me, don't get one with wheels. It's dangerous. So, anyway. That's way more about my life than anyone cares for. No offense. I'm not saying you guys are jerks and don't care about me, but let's be honest, like, how much stuff do we really need to know about my stay-at-home mom life? So, let's get on to the actual whips and stuff. It's done vlog style, so kind of as I went, and yeah, we'll have some future Stitchy plans and whatnot coming up. Yeah, you good baby.
All right, so it's a bad day today. Went to go hang out with a friend, and unfortunately I looked and her car seat wasn't installed. Because the husband went and got a used crib, which is great, but he didn't install a car seat. And I tried to look up instructions online, and I could not. I printed them out, and I couldn't for the life of me get that thing installed. So I'm stuck at home today. I'm pretty upset about it. I mean, I don't get to go out a lot. But instead, I have a finish. Oh god, I'm gonna show it to you guys, but you have to promise not to laugh, because I fully finished it, and it is quite possibly the ugliest fully finish there ever was. It's bad, okay guys? It's really, really, really bad. But, whatever. Alright. So I finished the snowman Mill Hill kit. Alright, I had a lot of fun with this. I guess I'm still gonna give it to my mom, even though it's horrible. I mean, we're talking bad. So, there we go, we got felt. Oh yeah, yeah, that's bad, guys. I mean, look. What is that? Because I cut too close, so I put a little dab of glue there. Oh god, it's so bad, I can't do it. Like, I can stitch. This is my first time beading, and most of my beads are not too bad. I mean, they're a little wonky. You know, like, these guys are hard. But, like, yeah. The stitching and the beads, not too bad. But the finishing, oh gosh, it's so bad. Okay. I hope you guys don't, like, ban me and not love me anymore because of this. But I'll explain. So, it says to use white glue and to take, you know, to actually glue it to something. I'm like, okay. We don't have white glue, but my husband has wood glue, yellow. Oh, God. So I did that first. And after a day, the glue didn't dry. So I was like, okay. So I just took the felt off of it, and I was like, whatever. I don't really care. And I just wanted to get it done. I really just wanted to get it done. So I hot glue gunned it, all right? I love the hot glue gun. It is the best way to just make a quick, easy finish of something. And actually, the hot glue gun worked great overall. But when I cut it out, like, so this is what I did. First, I cut the ornament out, and then I glued it, which I think was part of the mistake right there. Because, like, why did I do it that way? I could have just cut once. Or I could have done what I originally did, right? But then I could have instead, like, what I should have done is just left an edge of the felt on purpose. Like, and then I could have made it really pretty, like, just left a purposeful edge of felt around it. You know, like, a few millimeters or something. But instead, I glued it, and then, like, I cut it, cut too close here. Oh my god, this is so bad. And then I hot glue gunned it. And then I cut it out from the felt, and, like, as you can see, I am really not good with scissors. It's so bad! Ugh! Anyway, I hope my mom will still love me and still like it. I used a ribbon that I had for, stuff. For sorry. Oh, angry baby. Yeah, he needs attention. It's been a bad day for him, too. So yeah, this is it's the worst fully finished object of all time. I didn't watch a tutorial or anything, I'm not gonna lie. I just wanted to finish it so bad, and that was a mistake. So, next time, I will watch a tutorial, and I'll try to do it the right way. I'll be patient. I know, I'm gonna put my thumb over that glob, because it bothers me so much. Oh, it's just so bad. Oh well. I mean, it's not... I think my mom will still like it, but instead of it being, like, a nice, pretty present, it's like, here, I'm 8 years old, and this is what I made you, mommy. Like, that's how I feel about this. Ah, I suck. I guess this is why I deserve to stay home, huh? Anyway. Yeah, I think that kind of sums it up. But I finished it. And again, the stitching and beads look pretty decent. So, woohoo! Bye, guys. So this is the start of my Heaven and Earth designs, which is a time for sugaring. Time for sugaring. And I managed to do almost 1,000 stitches in it. The reason I'm laughing is because it's like I worked my tuchus off, and that's all. Yeah, Robin's here with me. He's gonna help. I worked my tuchus off, and this is all I managed to do in a week. It's not terrible, but it's like, yeah, my stitches are also a little sloppy. I need to get a snag nabbit to fix that one. Ugh. You can see my sloppy stitching. But you know what? It's going to be viewed like way from way back. So I am doing this on 18 count. This is, yeah, Magic Guide Ada. Huge, huge, huge piece of it. I actually really enjoyed working on this. It was great. I am going to, I'm losing my train of thought. I gotta hurry before Mr. Little Man gets annoyed. So, really enjoyed working on this. Most of this is actually only three colors. More colors start to arrive over here, but most of it's only three colors. Let's see. Despite the fact that I'm actually pretty happy with the progress I managed in a week, it's a little disheartening. It's not good enough because this thing's gonna take me like forever and a day. I calculated it, and if I just only worked on this project at that pace, it would take me 7 years. So I'm gonna have to speed it up. Eventually, I'll have more free time. Hopefully, it could be years before I have more free time, but then I should hopefully be able to bang this out faster. The other thing is for me to think about. I think I'm going to do what Pam Reed does from Pam's Crafty Corner, where she works on one of her full coverage pieces every other week, and I think I will eventually do that. At this point, I'm not going to be doing that, but eventually. Because right now, sorry, he's just so cute. He's like doing stuff with his hands. Because right now, I have too many projects I want to finish. I just can't afford the time. But eventually, I think it would be really cool to do that, and I would get through it faster. So, despite feeling disheartened by the size and enormity of this thing, I am really excited I started it. I'm very happy about it. And my husband just came out of the shower, so we're gonna stay focused on this piece so we don't get an eyeful of naked Mr. Mully. Mm. I love you too, dear. I'm staying focused on this piece!
I got a piece for you to focus on.
Oh my god. Anyway. So, yeah, I really had a lot of fun working on this. It's gonna take me so long to ever finish it, but that's okay. I still had fun, and I'm still gonna, keep checking on. It's gonna be ginormous because of the fact that I'm doing it in 18 count, because you can get an idea. This is a 14 by 14 Q-snap. Yeah, that's gonna be huge. And this is the first row of the first page. I've decided to try doing rows. I know Jessie Marie does that. I don't know why, I just figured I'd try rows instead of columns. No particular reason. Anyway, I hope you're all doing well. And yeah, we'll see what other stuff. Oh, I'll do this at least. Pardon the mess. Look at it. It's all snowy outside, and I've got my Christmas tree. Notice our plywood floors and the mess, the Christmas tree and the ornaments, but look at the snow. So pretty. Snow day. All right. Anyway, hope you're all doing well. Bye. Okay. Let's see some really good progress. Ready, guys? Wow, look at Devon Tree. Oh my god, it's really coming together. I actually didn't work on this nearly as much as I would have liked this week, but I feel like I still got a lot done. Part of it is because I had one bad day where I was in a bad mood and I was just like, I'm not gonna do any chores today, I deserve a day off, and I'm just gonna stitch. So I did. Got a lot done that day. But this is great. I finished the bird. You can just kind of see a few sloppy stitches in there. I really should get a snag nabbit, because I think I could fix that. But whatever, I'm not the type of person to care that much, but anyway. And then over here, my progress, I finished this leaf. This is all new, all down here is new, that's new, and all of that. So pretty darn good. Considering I didn't even work on it every day. Like, I had a limited amount of time, and I managed to get a lot done. I'm happy. Like I said, it's really coming together. I got page finishes. I finished this page, I'm almost done with page two. There's a third page, but it's like a few stitches over here. And I'm working on the last pages now. I'm really, really psyched about this. It's like, you can actually, it actually looks like really beautiful. And there's a lot to it now. Oh, this is exciting. And I actually feel like I'm going to finish it someday. One thing I'm doing is I'm modifying the trunk. I'll quickly show you guys. Here we go. So this is what it's going to look like when it's finished. I keep forgetting to show you guys this. So this is what Devontree looks like. So it's, So as you can see, I need to do this whole section here and fill in there. And that's, and of course, this trunk. So this actually isn't the chart, so I'm going to go ahead and try. Oh, I keep forgetting to tell you guys, like, what fabric and who it is and everything. This is by Simple Smart, as you can see here. So I'm not gonna do it too close because it actually does have it. It's just not gridded. As you can see by my amazingly, amazingly effective line there, I am not gonna do the whole trunk. I do plan on framing this in hoop and thus cutting out that big hunk of trunk, because that is gonna be way too long for me to stitch. And I think, you know, it'll look nice in hoop that way, because that's how it's actually advertised on Etsy. It's looking like that. So anyway, this piece is really coming together. I am super happy about it, and I seriously can't wait to be done with it someday. I don't know when. I'm definitely at least halfway done now. Actually, I would say maybe more, a little bit, not by a lot though, because that trunk is going to take a while. But that's why I've already started on it over here, because I'm just like, it's going to take me so long. But oh, isn't that pretty? I love the colors. I already mentioned the dye lot issue last time to you guys, so it's not really noticeable in this lighting, but oh, in person you can see it like hardcore. But whatever, I'm not redoing it. Hopefully my friend will be okay with it. But yeah, I'm happy with it, and I will be so glad when it's done. Okay, let's see some whip progress on Pretty Little New York. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and insert a picture of what it looked like before. But I am very happy with this piece. So I worked on it and I didn't really get a good stopping, like I wasn't happy with my progress. And then I had an opportunity because I visited my mom and I was trying to decide, it was during my quote unquote wild card week, and I was trying to decide like what to work on at her house. And I knew I wouldn't have a ton of time to work on stuff, but I was hemming and hawing, and in the end I decided to work on this because I couldn't work on my Mill Hill kit because it was for her. So I worked on this instead. I love this piece. I absolutely love it. The colors are just incredible. It works so well with my style, and I'm getting really good progress on it. I'm closing in on finishing this page, so I almost have a page finish. This side, not as much filled in, but you know, I'm making pretty good progress in my opinion. I'm very happy. Soon I'm going to be working on the bottom section, so I don't know, I might be close to about halfway done, because it's four pages and the other two pages are down here and they're smaller pages. But there's a lot of stitches in there, so I don't know. So I maybe half-ish done, I'm not sure. But I just know it's so much fun. I love working on it. It's beautiful. I'm obviously filling in certain holes. Like, we got more of the Statue of Liberty this time. I finally did the top of this one. Finally filling in some of this one. This part's like almost finished. This building, working down here. Oh, it's just so exciting and fun to do. I love Satsuma Street pieces. I can't wait to do more.
Sorry for the really bad lighting. It's night, so it's dark. I managed to convince the hubs to hold the baby so I could show you guys some haul. You can see some of it in the background already. So let's get started. One thing I forgot to mention is that for my birthday, my husband made me a scroll frame. Only problem is I don't have a stand for it. I think he's going to make me a stand at some point. So I haven't actually used it yet, but it's lovely. Isn't it pretty? He did such a good job. He loves me. But yeah, I can't wait to actually use it. I'm not complaining, by the way. I'm very grateful. Next, you can probably see I got the, you know, Christmas ornament. Yeah, I thought it was just cross stitch. Just cross stitch, you know, 2016 ornaments. I love this. I love almost every single ornament in this thing. It's just wonderful. I didn't actually stitch any of them. My mom was thinking of doing the one that was baby's first Christmas, but she didn't end up having time, which I totally understand. I think I might stitch it like retroactively. Might not. Who would blame me? No one will know. Okay. Next, I've got boring fabric. So I'll just show you some quick. You know, I got some 16 count Ada. I think this I got from my mom for Christmas. I'm kind of considering restarting the birth record for Robin on this fabric instead of the 14 count white Ada I was doing it on, but I don't know if it's worth it or not. I already cut that piece of fabric and everything. I have to see if it would fit on this. It might not even fit on this. It's pretty big, so it doesn't really matter. I didn't get a lot of progress, so if I restarted, no big deal. Got some boring old, you know, even weave, 28 count Lugana, antique white, you know. Ugh. Okay. Now, more interesting fabrics. I have some hand dyes now. Ooh, wait, before I get into the hand dyes. Accidental kind of mistake purchase / desire. I didn't know. I got some MCG textiles, Evenweave and linen. I know with the Evenweave, it's notorious for not being even. So if you're doing like stitching a circle or something, it'll come out as an oval. So I did get, unfortunately, I got two even weaves. I got mushroom and antique white. And I got, this is boring fabric, so who cares? And I got a 32 count linen. Now, I don't know if their linen is okay. I don't know. I've decided, what I'll do is I'll just make sure that I don't stitch anything really important on these. You know, they'll be good for like little projects, little things that aren't too big of a deal, and I'm not really worried about, you know, obviously no circles. and I think it'll be fine. I just won't, again, I won't stitch anything really nice or important on it. I'll use the other one, or I'll buy more fabric. It's not, you know, that kind of fabric is fairly inexpensive. But now, let's get to the hand dyes. So, I don't know which one I want to start with. I'll start with, I joined the Fun Fabrics, who you can find on Facebook. Fun Fabrics. I dropped my other fabric. The Fabrics of the Month Club. So I have the December fabric of the month, which is called Holly Jolly. I got mine as a 28 count even weave, 18 by 21 piece. I'll show you guys what it looks like. It's honestly, it's really pretty. I really like it. There we go. Woo. Check that out. Pretty cool, huh? I think it looks great. I have no idea what I'm going to stitch on it. I'm already stressed out about the whole Fabric of the Month Club thing. Sorry. It's just so pretty. Because of the fact that I'm the type of person that I don't like to just have things to have them. And I'm like, I need to have a purpose for all these fabrics. But for right now, I'm trying to chill because it doesn't hurt to have a little bit of a fabric stash, you know, so that, you know, same thing. I can stitch whatever on this at some point, but one more look. Yeah, really pretty. I'm very happy with it. Can't wait for the next one. And I'll have that to use for something. I'm not sure what. All right. Next piece of fabric is the first one I actually purchased, which is Fantasy Dyed Fabrics. Now, I got this piece of fabric for a specific project. I got it for Crescent Moon Dragon by Joan Elliott, but I decided to not use this piece. I'll show it to you first. It's really pretty. And I'll flip the other side there. Yeah. I have no idea if that's showing up even remotely. Yeah. See, the thing is, it's really, really pretty, but it's too brown gold, and there's too much of that color in the dragon. If it was more of this blue, more of like this side, it would be perfect, but unfortunately, it just doesn't work for that project. I did a floss toss and I posted on Stitch Mania and people were like, don't do it. And I trust their judgment, honestly. So I actually bought a different piece for that project, but I'm not going to show it at the moment. I'm sorry, because my updating schedule is all wonkity. And I'm currently working on that dragon right now, actually, with that piece of fabric. So you'll see it the next update. It's very, the piece I got instead is really pretty, so. Something to look forward to. All right, lastly, let's get into some charts and stuff. So, this I actually got for my birthday, but shortly after. But it was on back order. I got Celtic Summer by Lavender and Lace, which lots of people have this one. Lots of people have done this one, or at least this series. But I want to do it too. I don't have any plans to start this anytime soon, though. I mean, really not anytime soon. So it's going to be sitting for a while. I'm kind of, with Fantasy Dyed Fabrics, like, when I get closer to working on this one, I'm gonna try to get me a piece of fabric for it. I'm really bad at picking out fabric colors, though, so I might need help. Oof! Almost dropped my stuff! Okay. Next, I got these for Christmas. My mom got me a couple of, Gold Collection, Dimensions kits. I've got this pretty sweet ship right here. It is pretty damn sweet. I just think that's really cool. They aren't very big, but they're pretty intricate. I think they'll be fun. And I've got one other one. I got a geisha. I like my geisha here. She looks lovely. I think that same deal in terms of, you know, not super intricate, but fun. So I'm excited about that. Again, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have a lot of kits. Like a lot of kits. Next piece to show you. So my mom got me some stuff from 123 Stitch. She got me kitted up. I now have March and April of the Lizzie Kate yearbook series. And she got, I have all the weeks and I have the fabric, the two little pieces of fabric for it. So the next time I do one of these, sorry, looking at you guys. The next time I do one of these, I'm going to see what colors I have because, you know, if I see what colors I already have, I might not have to rebuy all the weeks and I can save some money. It's a light mocha cashel linen. Little piece. Two little pieces. But there's more in here. I also got Krennic for the Crescent Moon Dragon, which I don't have right here, so I'm not going to show it to you, but I don't think it's that interesting. No offense. So I also have the start to my project of doing a piece for all of major holidays, which will be 8 pieces. So we've got Happy New Year. Lizzie Kate is one that I decided on. It was about the only New Year one I could find. I think I'm going to do this pretty much in DMC, except for maybe that green in the hat, because that looks pretty variegated. Otherwise, you know, I think that's the only one I might bother with. And then I got one other piece, and I got the fabric for this other piece too, so let me grab that. Okay. And I got the Valentine's Day chart, which is by Country Cottage Needleworks, Be My Valentine. Isn't that the cutest? Oh, sorry. The lighting is so bad. There we go. Let's make you guys seasick. So that's super cute, isn't it? It's like super cute. Good news is it's mostly in DMC, so I think I have most of them. And then there's one color that's Classic Colorworks. So, and I actually do think I'm going to get it because it is variegated and it's kind of pretty. So I'm just going to have to find that. And my mom also got me the fabric for this one because I requested it specifically. I don't know why I wanted the fabric too. Like, it's not that interesting of a fabric. Why? I don't know. I asked her to get it. Anyway, it's a lamb's wool linen. Woo, you can see me. It's like super rough and scratchy. I don't think I'm gonna like stitching on this, but that's okay. I can handle it. I can handle it. So yeah, that's it. There is some other stuff, but you're gonna see that I think in my next update video. I have a couple of needle minders and one other color of fabric. I do have one last thing to show you. My mom gave me a lamp to stitch with. It's not a fancy one, it's Etex, and it's actually lighting my face right now, so I'm gonna get dirt real dark. There you go. Look at this thing. You know what's cool? It has colors. That is not, it's purple. You can, like, change the color. See my face changing color? It's pretty sweet, isn't it? But yeah, this has been handy, actually. I like it. I never have thought I need a light, but I totally do. Anyway, I hope you're all doing well, and hope you enjoyed my kind of slap-together haul there. I don't know how cooperative Robin's gonna be. I only have one part left to record for this Flossy video, and that is talking about a quick year in review and my stitchy plans for 2017. Also say hi to, Moody's over there, and we got Cedric and Skyla curled up on the bed. Sorry, the bed's not quite made. I don't really make the bed. It's a comforter on there. Anyway, I didn't have a lot of finishes this year. I only had 5. I had three of them were for my mom, too. I had a Mother's Day card for my mom. I did a present for my friend Paul, the Christmas piece for my mom, the snowman, and the Triceratops for Robin. Did 5 finishes. This coming year, I plan on doing, it's the bouncy ball thing. It's kind of silly, isn't it? It makes them happy. Anyway, so this coming year, I don't have any super lofty goals in terms of finishing, but I want to do the whole Lizzie Kate yearbook series, so that's 12 finishes right there, in theory, if I can do it. And I'd like to finish Devonshire and Pretty Little New York, and I'm rather confident that I should be able to finish those, assuming no disasters, knock on wood. Actually, this is a better type of wood right there. So anyway, I have to hope that everything goes well. Should be able to finish that stuff. Let's see, what else did I have planned? I have starts. So stuff I'm going to start. I'm going to start Crescent Moon Dragon by Joan Elliott. I'd like to do, Mini Lackadaisy Affinity by Heavenly Earth Designs. I forget who did the artwork for that one. I'm sorry, I'll try to insert it. Who did the actual artwork. I'd like to do that one. I don't plan on starting that one till more the second half of the year, though. It's not... a huge priority. I have a piece of fabric for it, but I'm thinking I'm going to do a different piece of fabric. I'm not sure what yet. I'm trying to decide between a 28 or a 25 count. And I think I'm going to do 2/1 tent because how long hades take. So I think that'll work out much better for me. There's one other hade I kind of want to start. I don't plan on starting it in the next year per se, but I do want to start it fairly soon. And I don't own it yet. It's a mermaid with a baby, and it's really freaking cute. And it's kind of corny, and I don't mean that in like an offensive, mean way. It's just, it's kind of corny, but I freaking love it, and I want it because I have a baby, and I don't know. After having a baby, I'm just like totally into the motherhood, you know, like just totally into it right now. So I'd like to do that one at some point. But I have to get all the materials. It's one without a background, so I can do a hand-dyed fabric for it. And I was calculating size, and it's a 28 count, and it would fit on a 28 count, 1/1, if I do 2/1 tent. So right now I'm in that Fun Fabrics Fabric of the Month, so I'm going to see if any of those fabrics, actually the first one I got might work because it's a purplier piece. I'm going to see if any of them work for this piece. If none of them feel like they're going to work, I'll buy something else, but I might start that one this year, but that's kind of iffy. That's really... and at some point, if I get really bored with everything I'm working on and I'm like, oh, I need a new start, I've got tons of my little kits and I'll start a little kit. Because there's so many of them and it's like, why not, you know? The other thing I wanted to briefly talk about, I'm not doing any sales or stitch-alongs this year. I probably could, and I'll talk about that in my next video, my next update. I probably could do a sal, but initially I just figured I had no time. Unfortunately, no time, and I just wouldn't be able to make that work. But maybe next year. And the thing is, it kills me because there's so many good ones this year. And I'm going to try to insert pictures as I'm talking about them, but I really can't guarantee it because it depends on how much editing time I have, which is really iffy. But there's the Frosted Pumpkin ones. That's fantastic, like Happily Ever After. I like that. The Clouds Factory, famous woman of history, like, oh, that's great too. And then, let's see, what are the other big ones that I really would have liked to have done? There's that Ship's Manor one, which is in the middle of, which is, like, in process right now. That one's freaking gorgeous, the Sea Quaker Sal or something. Oh my god, that one's just so pretty. I love that one. I might do that one later. Oh, you're so cute. I know. I'm testing your patience. There's... let's see. Oh yeah, there's the Under the Sea. Just straight up Under the Sea, which is the Lakeside Needlecraft. And I like the fantasy one is super cute. And this Under the Sea one looks cute. I saw the octopus came out. And then Brooks Books has this gorgeous dresses of like designed for certain Disney characters. And oh my god! Oh my god! I nearly died when I saw the Cinderella one. It's so pretty. I love it. I'm in love. Yeah, I know! I wish I could do that one! There's also, oh my god, there's so many of them. I'm sorry, I'm trying to think of all of them that I'd like to do. Stitchrovia just came out with one, and the proceeds benefit a charity for mental health awareness. Like, oh my god, that's great too. I love Stitchrovia designs. But there's just so many and I want to do them all and I wish I had enough time and money. Like, so, maybe next year. I guess my own Sal is doing the yearbook series by Lizzie Kate. That'll be fun. And I think he's had enough of me talking, so I... Ah.